In this screencast, I'm going to be showing you how to use VBA to extract data from multiple Excel files so we can consolidate information that's on multiple sheets into a single sheet. So for example, we're going to be working with a central Excel workbook. What we want to do is we want a VBA sub to go to different files, and we have information in these different files. It's going to open up that file. Sort of behind the scenes, it's going to extract some information from that file and bring it back into the central Excel workbook. So then it'll open up a second file, take information from that file, bring it into the central workbook. It'll open up a third file, a fourth file, and so on. And we could do this as many times as we wanted to, but during each iteration, removing some information from each of those files and bringing it into the central Excel workbook. The first thing I'm going to do is go over to Excel and use Alt F11 to bring up the Visual Basic Editor. I'm going to insert a new module, and we're going to name this Sub Import Data from Multiple Files. The first thing I'm going to do is dim file names as a variant. File names is going to represent an array that's going to be all the files that the user selects to import data from. We're going to be doing an iteration, so I'm going to dim I, which is going to be just an index of iteration. I'm also going to add something here called screen updating. Application screen updating equals false. The reason for that is this will make it so that when we're opening up those files and closing them, we are not going to be showing that in the background. It basically freezes it, and then it only gives us the result, which is the information that we want, into our central workbook. And then I'm going to select range A1, so cell A1 of our current workbook. Next, I'm going to define what this file names array is going to be. And I'm going to use this application.getOpenFileName. And we have a file filter. This is essentially where the user can browse for the files that he or she wants to import. So this is our name. And I need a quotation there. And we also have a title here, so title open file, that's going to be the title of the box that comes up, and multi-select is true, so that means we can select multiple files, and the files that we select is going to be placed into this file names array. Now we're going to perform an iteration through all the files that we are importing for I equals 1 to upper bound of file names, and we're going to be doing something. I'm going to put a next I here. But let me go back and show you. We've got five files that look like this, where we have one word in cell A1 of each of those five different files, and they're different words. And we're going to use this to import the name or the word that's in A1 into our main worksheet. Each time we're going to increment down by one cell, so we're going to put those five words in cells A1 through A5. So that's what we're doing with this. Let me close this, and we'll go back. We're iterating through those five files, and you could select more if you wanted to. So in each iteration, we're going to open file name I. We would open file 1, 2, 3, and 4, and during each of those, we're going to select range A1 from each of those five files. We're going to copy that selection, and then we're going to activate the main file name. So the main file is going to be called multi-importer, so I need to save this file as multi-importer, so I will do that. I'm going to save that as an Excel macro-enabled workbook. Go back to the editor. The next step, we've activated that main, the central file. Now, after we've copied that, and we've activated the multi-importer, the main sheet, we want to paste special, so we can use this selection, paste special, paste Excel, paste all. We want to transpose that, because normally if you paste it, it'll paste it as a row. We want that as a column. So we're going to transpose that. And then we want to go back over to the file that we're iterating through. And sometimes it doesn't work just to activate that new file, especially because file name is so big, we don't just have a specified file name. So we can use workbooks.openFileNamesI to reselect or reactivate the file that we're trying to import data from. And now we want to close that file. So we're going to active workbook close, We are not going to save changes, we're just extracting data. So we're going to close that workbook. And at the end of each import, we want to offset the active cell by one row and zero columns. Because then what that does is we're going to import it into A1, and then at the end of each iteration, we want to bump it down so it's ready for the next import. Otherwise, we're just overwriting cell A1 every time. Okay, I'm going to comment out this screen updating just to kind of show you what happens. And I think we're ready to go. The last thing I'm going to do is insert a button. I'm going to assign that sub that we created to that button. Maybe I'm going to just say import data. Okay, so I click that and it brings up this open file box. And you can navigate to your files. So I've got 5 files here, each with different words in cells in cell A1 of those respective sheets. So I'm going to open that, and you see it's going through, it's opening all 5 of those files, and it's sort of flashing, and it's importing cell A1 from all those 5 files. There's a different word in each of those, and then we put that in cells A1 to A5. So that is how it works, and we will turn this application screen updating to false now. I'm just going to clear this. You'll see it looks a little different now because with the screen updating false, it just sort of runs and then gives us the final result just in one fell swoop. That is how we can use VBA to import data from different files. And there's a lot of different things you can do with this. I hope you enjoyed this screencast.